My friend Bethan, she goes by Ledley now, she's a pop star, was on a music panel yesterday, and she was saying how she felt the pressure to... she feels like there are a lot of covers online that have, like, really high production value, and, like, almost she wants to, like, match the production value of, like, the released song, which I don't feel, because I don't feel like that matches my style. I feel like I've always been very homemade, and occasionally I'll try and, like, produce it a bit more, and then I'm like, well, this was fun, but back to doing what I actually can do. I don't know, I do feel like there's a very, like, distinct line between, like, me sitting in my room and, like, being on YouTube and then, like, going to a producer. I think what's really difficult about that, though, is that I haven't learned to produce. So in order to kind of take my music to the next level, as it were, and, like, to put it on Spotify, I have to bring it to someone else, and I have to share it with a producer and a mixer and a master and a master of rower, and then, like, I don't know, other people and, like, distributors. And it's, like, kind of you have to give your song to other people and allow their creative input, and that's been really difficult because I'm such a, like... I'm like, no, I don't like that. I want this. And it's really tough to kind of, like, have a song that was yours, have, like, other people's ideas in it, and kind of be like, I'm okay with this. I think it is a good technique to try because it can, like, you can make it better. It's just, yeah, like, giving it away.
When you're in your bedroom and you're just on your ukulele and you've got your fairy lights behind you and stuff, like, that's why people started watching you in the first place, and that's why people love watching you. And I've definitely found that when I do, like, a higher production video, it's never been out of choice. It's always been out of because, someone said, hey, we need you at this time to sing the song with the composer to promote the show, and we'll film it. And I'll be like, fine. And then I'll be like, can I put it on my channel? Because it was really great. Then as soon as I put it up, everyone's like, you've been paid to do this. I'm like, what? Don't worry about it.
I go, oh, my God, Carrie's voice. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
But, again, it's also, like, the immediacy of posting things that are unpolished, because you can just pick up a ukulele, stick your camera on, and then it's done within the hour and it's up. Whereas when you've got to, when you want to produce things, you've got to rely on so many other people to get it done, and it will take much, much longer.
I feel like there is this charm. I'm sorry. I'm just, like, talking. I'm sorry.
Go for it.
This charm with, like, the specific type of, like, kind of, like, mobile phone vertical video that's, like, low quality. Like, think of, like, the damn Walmart kid, you know? It was adorable. Like, he didn't have any equipment. He just is really good. And obviously it did so well because he's amazing. And everyone was like, wait, what? This tiny child? Anyway, went off a tangent. But I do think, yeah, there is this, like, nice quality about someone not, I don't know, trying too hard. I don't know what my point is. Just, what? Like, I guess my point is, like, if you don't have the, like, loads of equipment, it doesn't matter.
Which is another example of talent speaking for itself.
Yeah.